be quiet.
Look, I don't want to talk about it, all right?
Yeah, neither would I if I'd blame me only chance.
Now, it's too bad you're getting too big for your boots. Look, it's all your fault it was wrecked in the first place, so shut up, Kelly.
I just say, if you're going to do something, you might as well do it right.
I'm going to bloody well kill you!
Hey, come on, come
get off!
Kelly! Get off me, fat guts!
Come on, I'll take on the two of you. What's the matter? You're afraid to face me one-to-one? Some bloody top dog. You're all talk and no action.
Yes, it's Rep Kean. The women claim that Miss Ferguson has just been harassing her.
Ah, oh, what is it this time? A bashing, shoving straw up her fingernails? They've tried it all before.
Let's keep calm, please.
It's threatening to push her off the stairway up near solitary.
When did they claim this happened?
Less than half an hour ago.
Oh, Governor, this really is too much. I've been sitting here with you for at least an hour. Now, Kean's just trying to stir up trouble.
Either you admit the incident was a fabrication or somehow explain how Miss Ferguson managed to be in two places at once. Well?
Well, I don't know. See, I can remember being on the stairs and then I don't know. Maybe someone else was there or...
Oh, you were lying.
The bloke that did win the microwave oven and the $3,000 probably reckons that it's easier to climb barefoot up Mount Everest than to cook beef Wellington on national television. Merv Pringle.
During the 8 weeks following the patient's nervous breakdown, she was given electroconvulsive therapy a total of 27 times. Short treatment.
I knew they used it occasionally. 27 times? I mean, it's a wonder she's still alive.
Here, this will make you feel better.
Oh, thanks.
All right?
Look, I'm sorry I caused so much trouble with Ferguson.
It's okay. My fault for jumping in.
Nora, why would the women in Blackmore hate me? Well, Mrs. Reynolds wouldn't lie to me, would she?
Well, she's always played it straight with me. Why?
She reckons that all of the women in Blackmore hate me and I can't even remember.
Well, you're in Wentworth now, and as long as you don't tread on anyone's toes, you'll soon make friends.
Oh, you reckon? Lou hates me. I don't know why, but she does.
She been getting heavy?
I've never done anything to her. I wouldn't. Why does she hate me, Nora?
Lou can be a real troublemaker. She starts hassling you, you let me know and the council will deal with it.
Lag on her? Oh, Nora, you know I can't do that.
Yeah, Alexa got me peas ready to dish up and Mr. P's not even around.
Yeah, who needs him, huh?
Wonder how he's doing in that contest. Probably be over by now, I suppose.
Oh, who cares?
Change the subject, will you?
Hey, Lex, are you still upset about them designs of yours?
What do you reckon? It'd be nice to know what they thought.
Yeah.
Hey, I know! We can make him a cake.
Oh.
Mr. P.
What for?
Well, sort of like congratulations for being in the contest.
Look, he hasn't even won yet, Daph. We're going to look pretty stupid standing around a cake singing for he's a jolly good fellow if he's lost.
No, it's the thought that counts, Lex.
I wouldn't mind, would he? Daph, I know you're born yesterday, but that's a ridiculous idea.
Hey, look, we've got time. We can make it. Well, cakes are really easy. We'll make him, a chocolate fruit cake.
So you're going to coat yourself in chocolate, are you?
And we don't even need a recipe because cakes are really...
Oh, Daffy!
No, don't worry. I saw it on the telly. They have flour in them and... Oh, eggs. I hope it gets in the eggs.
Wasn't Mr. Russell Clark marvellous?
So were you, Joyce. You had more confidence in me than I did. But you wanted me to carry on with it when I wanted to give it away.
Nonsense. Now you know how talented you are. Won't this look marvellous on the bookcase?
Joycey, not there.
Why not? We're not just going to hide it away and forget about it.
Well, if that's the way you feel, Maybe we should put it in the kitchen at Wentworth.
Oh, Murford, what if someone pinches it?
No, they won't. They did try to help me. And it'd be good for them to see I appreciate it. And that they've got an award-winning chef cooking for them.
Oh, that's a lovely idea, Mervyn. After all, we will have the microwave at home as a trophy, won't we? Unless you're going to send that to Wentworth as well.
Of course not.
Anyway, congratulations again, Pet. I'm very proud of you.
I still can't believe it. Mm? Now, what are we going to do with the prize money? How would you fancy a new wardrobe?
What?
I thought I'd buy you some nice dresses or a fur coat or something.
No, you spend the money on yourself.
There's nothing I want. Ah, maybe we could go to Fiji or somewhere.
Maybe you could just put the money in the bank until you need it. There is no point in frittering it away.
I'm just going to have to surprise you, aren't I? Oh,
Mervyn, you're very sweet.
Now, what shall I make for dinner tonight? Beef Wellington a la Pringle? Oh,
I think you've done quite enough cooking for one day. No, tonight we are going out for dinner to celebrate. Cheers.
Cheers.
Oh, that's delicious.
Kean?
I want a word with you.
What about?
Why did you have Flynn tell Mrs. Morris that I attacked you?
Oh, I don't know. I thought you did.
I was with the governor. Now, did someone attack you? Someone you thought was me?
Yeah, well, it must have been.
Where? What happened?
Well, I was on the catwalk, see?
And?
And, there was someone there on the stairs. Behind me, I think. Oh, no! No, you attacked me! You tried to push me over!
That all happened a long time ago, and it was you who attacked me.
Me?
Yes, you very nearly killed me.
Oh, no.
You remember Blackmore?
Yeah.
Well, what happened there?
They sent me to the hospital to make me better.
Why, were you sick?
Well, I must have been.
And how did they make you well?
Doctors. They had good doctors there.
Did they give you ECT?
Oh, I'm not sure. The pills. I remember the pills.
What else do you remember?
Oh, friends. You see, I thought I had these friends at Blackmore.
What about Cynthia? Do you remember Cynthia Leach?
Is she a friend of mine?
Do you remember her?
Look, I don't! Who is she?
Just a friend. Oh, and, thanks, Kean. You've given me all the answers I want.
Kelly, we've come to a decision.
Yeah, whoopee.
I don't give a damn whether you like the idea of the council or not.
I don't. I thought you would have known that by now.
Lexie's clothes were a good chance for her. Could have opened a lot of doors for her when she got out.
Oh, come off it. Who would have paid good dough for that crap?
Exclusive boutiques, that's who.
The fact is that you've done everything you can to blow it for her. Your punishment's 2 weeks loss of buy-ups. Now get out of here.
2 weeks, you stuck
get
up
out. You're sounding more like Reno every day, Flynn.
She's more than a worry, that one.
Oh, now, what's the matter with you?
Poor Lexie. A chance of a lifetime gone just because of her.
Oh, Willie, we don't know that. Lexie hasn't heard yet.
OK, we've got one more thing to discuss. Reb Keane.
Are you sure she's not faking?
I'm pretty certain, but what exactly is going on, I'm not quite sure. It's not like she's got amnesia like Willie had.
I wasn't faking. Not the first time.
So you keep telling us.
Reb can remember most of what's happened, except for what she calls her blank spots. Sort of memory gaps in between what she can remember.
She's making the whole thing up.
Maybe she doesn't want to remember. Psychosomatic after whatever happened at Blackmore.
We really knew what happened. Maybe we could help her.
We're not qualified. We could just make it worse.
Maybe Reynolds could help by tracking down her mum.
Oh, I still think you're barking up the wrong tree. Keane's having us all on.
What makes you so sure?
She never needed no one's help. That's why she calls herself Reb, short for Rebel. Ask Lou.
I wouldn't trust anything Kelly said.
Okay, let's take a vote on it. Do we help her or not?
Yes.
Yes.
Lurch?
Waste of time me even being here, I reckon.
How's it going? What do you want? Tough luck about your buy-up.
Who cares? I got plenty in here who owe me favours.
Yeah, sure. Hey, you want to hear the latest? They're going to try and help poor little Reb get her memory back.
What? Don't they know she's putting it on?
You Well, I tried to tell him, but my opinion's not worth nothing with him these days.
Oh, hell. Red did the same thing to Myra before she took over. Didn't you tell him about the James Dean stunt with the cane?
Sorta.
Well, did you or didn't you?
Well, I forgot, didn't I? Geez, it's hard enough getting him to listen to me without having to think about that.
Yeah. Well, maybe it worked out better this way.
Hey? How do you figure that?
Well, I'll just keep it under me hat till I'm ready to use it. It's gonna make Flynn look pretty stupid, eh? Just after she's finished convincing everyone what a goody two-shoes Kean is.
Yeah, good thinking, Lou.
Yeah. Well, at least one of us is. Now, rack off.
I'm reading.
The Sheridan inquiry into police corruption was released to the public today amid great controversy.
How are you, Red?
Fine, thanks. That any hint of corruption in the force would be investigated thoroughly and immediately.
Jeez, those cops couldn't be on the take, could they?
On the take, on it, mate.
It's all a bit on the nose, if you ask me.
On a lighter note, they also saw the culmination of the annual Australian home.
Hey, this is what it is.
All over the state vied for the first prize of a trophy, a microwave oven, and $3,000. Peter Russell Clark. The winner of the event was Mr. Mervyn, head chef of Wentworth Detention Centre. Now it's time
for. What do they mean, head chef? He's the only chef.
I knew I should have put first prize on that cake.
What cake, love?
Oh, I made Mr. P a congratulations cake. It turned out really good.
What a lovely idea.
You should have entered the competition yourself, Daphne. You might have won.
Oh, come off it. It was a cooking contest, not a brick-making competition. You helped me to do it.
Oh, don't you try and get out of it. It was your recipe.
Yeah, but you told me some of the things to put in it, remember?
Yeah, well, I've never heard of a cake without sugar.
Better have a competition of our own to sort this out.
That's a good idea.
Mrs. Reynolds never let us into the kitchen all at once.
Well, you should be barred for life for your effort.
Yeah, Mr. P wouldn't like us messing up his kitchen anymore.
Pity, it would have been fun.
Well, what about some other sort of competition?
Like what?
Well, how about a dress designing competition so we can give Lex a chance?
Oh, very bloody funny.
Well, hey, what about a beauty contest?
Oh, that's a great idea.
That's a totally absurd idea. I say no.
Oh, Willie, we could all use some fun. Why not?
Don't be naive. Dear Miss Wilder will win it hands down. There'll be no competition at all, really.
Really, I wouldn't go in it. Really, I wouldn't. And not that I agree with
you. Hey,
what
well, all right, then I've got another idea.
Oh, come on.
No. What I was going to say was, if Eve doesn't want to be in it, why don't we get her to organise it and then she won't be out of it?
Yeah. Oh, that's good, Daph. What about it, love?
No, I've never done anything like that before.
Do you think I could? Of course you could. You're the obvious choice. You haven't got any work duties.
Yes, but
no buts. You'll do a great job.
All right, I'll try.
Good on you, love.
And what's the prize going to be? A world trip for two?
Oh, I'd settle for a chance to get out of here for a couple of hours. See how my screen prints are going.
Well, look, we could ask Mrs. Reynolds if we could charge an entrance fee and then buy the winner a prize.
Yeah, what about cosmetics or perfume or something?
Yes, now you mention it, it would help to free up the trade situation. It has been a bit bogged down lately.
Well, what do you reckon, Reb? You going to go in the beauty contest?
Oh, I think you'd be really good at it, Julie.
No, are you going to go in it?
Oh, no, thanks. I'll give it a miss.
She's not well, Mrs. Morris. If you ask me, they left her out of the mental hospital too soon.
Oh, what do you mean?
Well, she's not violent or anything. Doesn't seem a danger to anyone except herself.
Yes, well, it's hardly surprising after the shock treatment she received.
What shock treatment?
Why, didn't she mention it?
No.
Well, she was given a course of ECT.
Crops, they don't fool around, do they? What brought that on?
Well, I don't know. I mean, I'm no expert. But I think the amount she was given was excessive.
What do you mean by excessive?
Well, according to a file, she was given it 27 times.
27? What about the bashing she took?
Well, apparently that was quite serious. Other than that, I can't tell you any more. All we can do is take it up with the proper authorities. But watch her, will you?
Mm. Well, we can have a few different parades. We can have the first one in day wear and the second one in evening wear. Another way in swimwear.
Hear that, Willie? You better take the mothballs out of your bikini.
They're the only things that keep it in any shape.
What's going on?
We've decided we're going to have a beauty contest and Eve's going to organise it for us.
Hey, why don't we advertise it in the free press? Eve could write a big article about it.
Oh, if you wanted to.
Oh, I don't think I'd be
Look,
very
I
good.
Hate to interrupt the fun, but I've got something important I want to talk about. Reb, mind coming over here?
No.
I've just been talking to Mrs. Morris, and it seems when Reb left Blackmore, they put her through a course of electric shock treatments.
What?
Which would probably account for why she can't remember things.
Hey, is that when they stick them wires on your head and turn the switches on?
Not exactly. You poor love.
They don't still do that to people, do they?
It can help sometimes. It's called electroconvulsive therapy, ECT.
Oh, Miss Ferguson asked me about that, and I couldn't remember.
How could you let him do something like that to you? I couldn't.
Didn't they give you a choice of other treatments, or at least tell you about them?
Other treatments? No, just ECT. That's what it's called.
Well, didn't they get your permission before they started?
No. I don't know. Well, nobody asked me.
It's a violation of human rights. Are you sure you didn't sign some kind of consent form or something?
No, but they wouldn't have given it to me if I didn't need it. Well, they were good doctors.
I think we should do a full-page cover story in the next paper. Maybe Mrs. Reynolds can do something. Yes. You know, like she did when she let me see my mum in hospital.
Yeah,
oh, your story will probably have to wait. Oh, that's
fine. The main thing is we should all help Reb to settle in and adjust back to normal. The sooner the better. Mm.
Aren't we going to do something about it, apart from the paper?
We'll make the newspaper story the first stage in a longer campaign. We might have to go over Reynolds' head on this one.
Oh, yes, I think so. Oh, look, thanks all of you, but there's no need to go causing trouble on my account.
Oh, yes, there is.
I wouldn't have let it. Yeah? Well, you don't understand. They made me better, see? All I want is to be left alone.
Well, I'm telling you, Cynthia, she doesn't remember a thing. Not you, not the women, nothing.
You might be prepared to take the chance, Joan, but I'm not.
What do you mean?
I mean that if she drags me down, I'm taking you with me. I only got mixed up with Kean in the first place because of you.
Look, I've got the governor breathing down my neck all the time. There's nothing I can do.
I don't know. It wouldn't cause too many ripples of Reb Kean top to self, would it? With a little help, of course. Well, would it?
Come in. Flynn's here. Are you ready to see her now?
Yes, bring her in.
Flynn? Morning, Nora. No trouble, I hope.
If you don't approve of this, you'll probably have a riot on your hands.
Meaning?
The women want to hold a beauty contest, that's all. Oh. It was Daphne's idea. I think she was inspired by Mr. Pringle winning the cooking contest.
Well, I don't see the harm in it. Mrs. Morris?
Oh, I think it's a great idea. It'll take some organising, won't it?
We've persuaded Eve Wilder to organise it. She's not on work duty.
Oh, yes, that's good. Give her something to take her mind off her problems.
Yes, we'll work out the details, Nora, and get back to
me. We've worked out some of the details already, as a matter of fact, like awarding a prize for the winner.
That's up to the women, surely.
Well, Eve thought it would be nice to award something different for a change, not sort of biscuits or cigarettes.
Such as?
Not quite sure yet. We could charge an entry fee and subtract that from our earnings and buy something really nice with that.
Well, it's a possibility, I suppose. I'll have to get the department's approval, of course. I need to have a better idea of what the prize is going to be.
We'll get back to you. Would it be all right if the women wore their own clothes? Be a big morale booster?
I think we can organise that if the department plays ball. Now, if there's nothing else, I've got a lot of work.
Okay, thanks for your time.
Oh, Flynn.
Yeah.
Kean, any trouble?
Nothing we can't handle.
Well, if it isn't Miss Australia. Or is it Miss Universe these days?
You can be very childish.
Oh, sorry, I forgot. You're the sophisticated type, aren't you? The kind he likes living off rich blokes. You're a bit stupid shooting him, weren't you? Can't give you much of nothing when he's dead. It's a rush. I was talking to you.
Well, I'm not talking to you.
Oh, yes, you are. You're going to tell me all about how much you miss him and just how good he was in the cop. Oh!
You shouldn't
have
done that.
Now you back off before I do some real damage.
Ladies, could I have your attention for a moment?
Jeez, I thought it was a fire alarm or something.
I want to tell you all that I asked especially for you all to be rostered on again this morning.
Oh, thanks, Mr. P.
And I want to thank you all for rallying around and getting up that terrific meal last night when I was recovering from the contest. I've heard nothing but good reports.
Yeah, well, it'd have to be better than that disaster Beecham knocked up for lunch.
I'm sure she did her best.
Yeah, well, if that was her best, I'd hate to see her on a bad day.
I'd also like to thank whoever it was who organized the women to give me those three chairs at breakfast.
Three guesses.
Oh, that was very nice. That was a little embarrassing. Oh, I thought you'd like to see the trophy I won.
Oh, yeah. Everyone said it looked real swish on the telly. Hey, Merv, what's that, you know, Peter Russell Clark bloke like in the flesh?
Oh, wonderful. Quite wonderful.
No, but I mean, is he a spunk or what, you know?
I'm not really qualified to comment, am I? Well, here it is.
Wow. Hey, you better give him yours, eh, Daph?
What's that?
Oh, it's nothing. Go on!
All right.
Oh.
Hey, Daph, I said T, not D.
Oh, did you?
Oh, never mind. It's just the thought that counts. Thank you very much, Daphne.
Yeah, it's my own invention, just like your stuff.
Well, how about we all have a slice for morning tea?
Oh, look, it's okay. Thanks, Merv. I'm not real hungry right now.
Well, the rest of us then. Right. Now then, it's a little crisp.
It's like one of them rock cakes, isn't it?
Lovely.
You said it, not me.
Lovely present. I can't wait to try it. Now then.
What's it like, Merv?
Very nice stuff. Very nice.
Guard just brought that in for you. Special delivery in a police car, no less. Hey, do you want some coffee?
Oh, yes, please. Oh, perhaps it's a ticket to the policeman's ball.
Joyce Barry. Oh, no, Sue, she's in D block this morning? Hmm. All right. Well, something exciting or just a parking ticket?
Well, it's from Inspector Grace. It's about Frank Burke. He's pleaded guilty to the shooting and is awaiting sentence. We're just returning the evidence.
Oh, man. It's your engagement ring.
You know what'll happen, don't you? We open it to all and sundry. Even Willie would enter.
What's wrong with that? I brush up very well when I want to.
Come on, we're both a bit old for that sort of thing, love.
Rubbish. What about Joan Collins and Raquel Welsh and Ursula Andress and Beau Diddley?
Beau Derrick.
Yes, her too.
I thought we decided anyone can join in who pays the entry fee.
Help me.
Oh. Who was that? Reb, quick, the chair.
Oh,
Reb, come on, the chair.
They bashed her.
Willie, go get a screw. She'll have to go to sleep.
No, 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 please. She said she'd kill me if I said what happened.
Don't worry about Kelly. She won't be up to anything by the time we're finished with her. You never learn, do you, Kelly?
Well... if it isn't the Lone Ranger and Tonto.
Well, you're up before the council again.
Oh, rack off, will you? Worse than the screws. What am I supposed to have done this time?
You bashed Eve Wilder.
Oh, come off it. She hit me, so I hit her back. So what?
Listen, you're lucky we were able to patch her up without the screws finding out. Otherwise, you would have had them on your back as well.
What did you do? Get her from behind while her back was turned?
What are you on about? I slapped her. That's all that happened. Just be in the rec room before lunch. Hey, Flynn, I want a word with you.
Alone.
What about?
You sit alone.
You're not going to try and buy me off, are you?
Seems to me that you're a bit off the air of late.
Every Tom, Dick and Harry's putting one over on you.
Such as?
Well, such as Wilder. I don't know what the bitch is playing at, but I hardly touched her. Oh, yeah. And then there's Kean. She's got you eating right out of her hand, hasn't she?
She's had a rough time, okay?
Oh, like him she has. She's taken you for a ride.
Convince me.
Well, you heard what she was like. The big James Dean fan. Going around with her collar up and combing her hair back.
The whole bit.
So?
So she's got you believing she doesn't do it anymore.
And she's forgotten all about it.
Right?
Right.
Well, it's bull. Because I seen her myself in her dorm.
Combing her hair back like she'd never been away.
What does that prove?
Oh, wake up, Australia. She's setting you up. She's trying to take over again.
You'll have to do better than that, Kelly.
I made a deal with her not to tread on me toes.
Waste of bloody time that was. Bitch will never learn.
I'll check it out. Hey, wait a minute. What about the council? I told you that Wilder was lying, didn't I?
Just be there.
I'm sorry. I'll try and be more careful.
It's all right, it's just a bit tender, that's all. Oh, look at this, it's ruined. It was so expensive.
We can probably find someone here who can fix it. I think it's just the seams that have gone.
Oh.
If I were you, I'd be more concerned about those. You could be left with some really bad scars.
Oh, it should be all right in a few days.
Do you really think I might be scarred for good?
I don't know. Some of the scratches are pretty deep.
Oh, I hope not.
Wouldn't he care if you were scarred?
A few weeks ago, I'd have cared. Now I'm just scared I'll be stuck in this place for the rest of my life. I wake up at night in terror. I can't bear it. I just can't bear it.
Eve, we all have nightmares when we first come in here. But your case hasn't even been heard yet. And if your lawyer's as good as you say
he is... I haven't heard from him for days.
I still wouldn't worry. He's probably just busy preparing your case.
But why hasn't he rung? Why hasn't he phoned me?
You know, I heard exactly the same thing from Jenny. She was frantic. She hadn't heard anything from her lawyer right up until the night before the case.
Poor thing.
But he was there when she needed him, and he did a terrific job for her.
I know David's the best there is, but what if he's changed his mind and he doesn't want to defend me anymore?
Why would he do that?
Adrian did.
Who's Adrian?
Oh, don't mind me. I'm so upset. I don't know what I'm saying.
How are you, Rebel? Found yourself a cause?
Hey, what do you mean?
You and James Dean against the world.
James Dean? He's a movie star, isn't he?
Yeah, real good at putting on an act, like combing his hair back and turning his collar up. I hear you made a deal with Kelly to stay out of her way.
Oh, it wasn't a deal. Oh, she told me I had to. She threatened me. First, I didn't know what she meant.
That's all you do, the whole James Dean bit. Your trademark, isn't it?
I don't know. Well, I was sort of combing my hair, but... Well, she'd already gone anyway. I don't know why I did it. I just sort of... It just happened, you know?
That's not what Kelly thinks.
Oh, yeah? Well, why does she hate me? I wouldn't do anything to her. Oh, no, I just want to be left alone.
Oh, Nora... You believe me, don't you?
Yeah. I'm sorry. I just had to be sure.
I just wish I could remember all these rotten things I'm supposed to have done.
That was the past. It's over now. Forget it.
But it keeps coming back. That Miss Ferguson, she reckons that I've got this friend at Blackmore. Well, maybe she could help me.
Who?
Cynthia. Lester?
Not Leach.
Yeah, Cynthia Leach. She's my friend.
Reb, Cynthia Leach is a screw. She makes the freak look like Doris Day.
A screw? Oh, oh no!
What is it?
Oh no! No, please! Ah! Get away from me! Oh no!
Did you manage to trace her mother?
No, unfortunately. Seems she's remarried and moved overseas.
Permanently?
At least a year. Do you think we should call Dr. Weissman in?
Well, I really don't know. I mean, Ingleside gave her a clean bill of health. And she doesn't seem too bad. She's cooperative, friendly. Just a bit confused, that's all.
I suppose that's to be expected after what she's been through. Let's give her a few more days, see how she settles down. She seems to get on all right with the women.
Oh, Nora seems to have taken her under her wing.
Yeah, so that should help. Perhaps our luck will change and she won't turn out to be such a big problem after all.
You better hurry. Counselor waiting for you.
You did a good job on yourself, didn't you, eh?
Oh, I don't know what you mean.
What the hell are you playing at, you bitch?
Don't try anything, Lou. You're unpopular with the women as it is.
Why are you setting me up like this?
To get you off my back.
Oh, you must be crazy to do something like that to yourself.
I didn't.
You did. Oh, that's crap and you know it.
Doesn't matter what you or I know, it's what the women think that counts. And you're not exactly playmate of the month at the moment.
Don't you get tough with me, Wilder. You're not going to get away with this, you know.
Won't I? We'll see. If you so much as come near me again, I'll have the women down on you like a ton of bricks.
Huh? And what are you going to do to convince them? Rip your bloody arms off?
That's what it takes.
You're psycho. You know that?
And you're finished if you ever lay another finger on me again.
I'm telling you, I hardly touched her. Look, okay, so I hit her with a nail polish and I traced her cell. But I'm telling you, the woman's crazy. She staged the whole thing to get back at me.
Well, how did she get those terrible scratches on her shoulder then?
She did it to herself.
Oh, rubbish. The poor thing practically crawled into the laundry for help.
nothing but an act.
We seem to have a lot of good actresses here, according to you. First Reb, now
Look,
Eve.
You believe what you want to believe. Why ask me questions at all?
Look, just tell us your version of the fight again.
I'm telling you, there was no fight. She hit me in the gut, so I gave her a backhander. Her lip was bleeding, that was all.
Just her lip?
Yeah, just her lip.
And then what happened?
I told her to rack off and she did. Next thing I know, Flynn's chucking a heavy in me dorm.
Any more questions?
No.
Wait outside.
Oh, this is a bloody joke. Consider your verdict. Why don't you go play kangaroo court with somebody else for a change?
Seems pretty cut and dry.
I suppose so.
Got a niggle?
No, it's all right.
The woman's as guilty as sin.
Well, it looks that way. I mean, it's certainly her style.
Oh, yeah, well, maybe she's getting a bit ahead of herself.
All we have to do now is work out a punishment for her.
Hi, Lex. You doing some more designs, are you?
No, it's open heart surgery. What do you reckon?
Wonder how long the council's going to be. It's real boring not being able to get back in the rec room.
Yeah, you can say that again.
What are you designing on this one?
Look, Daph, will you leave me alone? I'm trying to concentrate.
Oh, sorry.
And do me a favour.
Yeah, what?
Stop apologising for being so dumb, okay?
Oh, hell!
What's the matter? What is the point of me doing any more of these bloody things if I don't even know if they're like the first lot yet?
They'll tell you, won't they?
Of course they will, stupid. Just want to know when.
Sorry, Lex.
Oh, there you go again, apologising.
Oh, yeah, sorry. Oh, sorry.
Tell me, you buggers!
The fact is, Kelly, that you don't give a damn for anyone except yourself.
Oh, do me a favour and skip the lecture, will you?
Sorry, I thought you'd finished.
Almost.
Come to gloat, have you, bitch?
Shut up, Kelly. You may as well hear this. That little roughing up has just cost you an extra 2 weeks' buy-up, and you get to clean Eve's cell every day for the next week.
Oh, like
Maybe
hell!
Maybe you prefer it if we use you as a punching bag or let the screws deal with you.
Lag on me?
Just show them the evidence. We've all got alibis. What about you? Stick it, the lot of you.
I didn't mean to get her into so much trouble.
She's only got herself to blame, dear.
Well, maybe it's my fault.
How could it be?
Well, I came here with my makeup and clothes, and I guess it's only natural some of the women to be jealous.
That doesn't give anyone the right to go around bashing people.
Thank you, all of you.
For giving her what she deserved?
No, for being friends. When I was first sent here, well, I didn't realise I'd be meeting people like you.
Well, we're not about to sit by and watch you bullied around, especially by the likes of Kelly.
Are you going to enter the beauty contest, Reb? I am. You've got to be in it to win it. Not that I will. Win it, that is. I've been ugly all my life.
Hey, Jen, you've got to come and sit here. I'll save you a place. Reb and me have been talking about the beauty contest, haven't we, Reb?
I heard about that. Sounds terrific.
Jen here is a really good piano player. You should hear her sometime. She's given me lessons.
I'm not that good, really.
Oh, yes, you are. She's going to have her name up in lights one day. Jennifer Hartley, best piano player in the world.
Hartley? Yes. Why?
What, are you any relation to the Mrs. Hartley of Stonehaven?
She was my grandmother. Did you know her?
Oh, not really. She was a client of my father's. He's a stockbroker. How did you remember that? I don't know. It just sort of came.
Oh, do you remember anything else about your family?
Well, I remember my mother was beautiful. And my brother, he was... Well, we used to get on really well. Don't know why they haven't come to see me. Suppose they think I'm still in hospital, eh?
Well, why don't you phone them? Let them know you're here.
Could I?
Of course you can. I mean, they're your family. They're important to you. Apart from anything else, you've got a right to see them.
Oh, I'd really like to.
Didn't they come and visit you in the hospital?
I don't know. Well, I suppose they did, otherwise I wouldn't remember them, would I?
Well, one thing's for certain, we're going to do everything we can to help you find them.
Sit down, Patterson. I've just had a call from Pippa about your garment designs.
Oh, I knew it. They hated them, didn't they? The whole thing was a disaster, wasn't it?
Quite the opposite. According to Pippa, they positively raved about them. The whole promotion was a great success, and they want to know how soon you can get out the next order.
Oh, well, whenever they like. I can knock them up in no time.
Good. Now, I understand you have quite a few of the women to thank for getting the first lot out on time.
Oh, yeah, but I'll do it all myself next time. I mean, they'd just help me a bit.
Got my way most of the time, you know.
It's the reason all this happened in the first place that worries me.
What do you mean?
I mean, if we see the same sort of destructiveness during the next batch, I'll have no choice but to put a stop to all future work, do you understand?
Yeah, sure.
All right, that'll be all. This is a big opportunity, Patterson. Don't spoil it for yourself.
No worries.
And another thing, I won't have you flaunting this success in front of the others. You owe a good deal of it to them.
Right, mail for ladies. There's not much today, I'm afraid.
The way the post office is these days, I suppose we're lucky to get any at all.
Spencer? Young? Jenkins? Oh, beauty. Who's it from?
Oh, why don't you read it and find out?
Kennedy? Flynn? And Fisher?
You're doing well. Second one in 4 days.
Got myself a pen friend.
Really?
Probably one of those chain letters, you know, send it on or have bad luck for the next 12 months.
Well, there's half a dozen so far.
What?
Names on the list of the beauty contest. Oh. Even if we charge $5 each, we're not going to have much for a prize, are we?
Well, give it time, there'll be more.
Oh, always the grand optimist. And what do you suggest we should get with this vast sum you're so convinced we'll have to spend?
Oh, well, how should I know? Why don't you ask Eve? She's supposed to be organising it.
Pardon me for living.
You all right, Nora? It's not bad news, is it, mate?
Depends. It's a message from my mother. Did they even write it herself this time? Seems she's immigrating overseas and wanted to let me know a few things before she left. Listen. She deeply regrets being forced to abandon you in the orphanage and wants you to know how much she loves you and how much she thinks of you. After all this time, it's crazy, isn't it? So close. One minute I hear from her for the first time in over 30 years and then just when I think I'm going to see her again, I find out that I can't.
I suppose I should send this back to him.
Knowing Dennis, I think he'd want you to keep it.
Just doesn't seem right somehow.
Well, at least Frank Burke's been brought to justice. It'll be a long time before he's released.
Yeah, took the easy way out, though, pleading guilty.
Better than a long, drawn-out trial, surely.
Just that sometimes I think I would have enjoyed testifying against him.
No. Probably just as well it didn't come to that. You would have had to relive the whole thing.
Don't you think I have? Well, I better get back to work.
Funny the way the past has of catching up with you. First a card, then a mysterious letter. I still can't understand why she didn't write it herself. What difference would it have made? This is so impersonal, so second-hand.
Well, scared, I suppose. Well, put yourself in her position. Would you know what to say?
I'm sure I wouldn't.
I wonder who this Mrs. Davis is.
Well, obviously someone very close to her. Look, why don't you write back and find out?
What's the point? She obviously doesn't want to see me, otherwise she would have written the letter herself.
But we just discussed
that. It's taken over a week to get here. By the time I write to her, she would have gone already.
God! So unfair.
Why did she do this as Mrs. Davis? Didn't she realise how frustrating it would be to get something like this and be stuck in here? I mean, if I was outside, I'd be able to do something, but in here. But it's my mother, for God's sake.
You do want to see her then?
Well, of course I do. You just spent the last 10 minutes convincing me I should.
I just want to be sure that you do. It can be painful to find out.
I want to find out. And the sooner the better.
Yeah, well, I have to start work on them straight away. Might even up the price, I reckon.
Oh, don't jump the gun, young lady. You're not exactly Prue Upton, you know.
Cliche.
Hey, Lex, I had an idea.
Oh, you and everybody else, look, if they need any help, I'll ask for it, okay?
We could have a mini fashion show. Get the girls in the beauty contest to model your designs.
What, me? Wear those tattered rags, never.
I don't know. It's not a bad idea, I guess, but what if they get ruined?
I would have thought you'd be more scared of them being repaired.
Oh, madam having a go at those clothes of yours again, is she?
Jules reckons we could use them in the beauty contest.
Hey, that's a good idea.
Hey, we could have... No, you'd think it was stupid.
Come on, love, out with it. The last one was a good one.
Well, I was thinking we could have a talent section combined with a beauty contest, have accumulating points for each bit, and anybody that wants to do an act, like sing or dance or eat fire or whatever, they could.
That'd be good for a laugh, actually. What do you reckon, Nora?
Sounds good to me.
Maybe we should let the screws enter. Mrs. Barry could give us a tap dance.
Yeah, and the freak could turn on a strip show.
I wonder what Rado would do in a talent contest.
Sing arias from Madame Butterfly.
That's not a talent, it's a handicap.
Oh, Nora.
It's Kean. She wishes to make a phone call.
Oh, to whom?
Her mother.
Oh. Where is she?
Outside. I thought I'd better bring her in to see you first.
Yes, bring her in, will you? Kean?
I understand you want to phone your mother.
Yeah, well, I was told I had a right to.
Look, I'm sorry, but we've made some inquiries. I'm afraid she's gone overseas.
Oh. Well, what about me dad, then? He doesn't take holidays. He'd be home.
I'm afraid your father died some time ago. Your mother's remarried now.
Oh. I didn't know.
I understand she's overseas with a new husband.
Watch where you're going, you stupid bitch!
I'll pull your head in. Don't want to get reported to the council again, do we?
Oh, you reckon you're the cat's whiskers now? Just because some trendy poofter bought a couple of your lousy T-shirts.
Yeah, tough luck your sabotage didn't work. You won't get another chance, will you?
Don't bank on it.
You touch my gear and your life won't be worth living. Every woman in this place is onto you.
And who says I'm going to be next? You're getting an awful lot of others cheesed off, you know.
Meaning?
All that skiting of yours gets up people's noses. Nobody likes a smart ass, Patterson. Especially not one as far up herself as you are.
Well, don't go near my gear again, because I'll be keeping a close eye on it.
You need to.
I love you, Kelly.
Yeah, well, I can understand me mum wanting to get married again. She wants somebody to look after her, to love her.
Do you remember much about your family? I mean, when you were a little girl?
Oh, bits and pieces, yeah. You know, sometimes if I think really hard, I can remember better. What do you think that means I'm getting me memory back?
Whatever it is, it's a good sign.
You know, I remember something about me and me brother going down to the creek to get yabbies. Yeah. He fell in. I got roused at for not looking after him. Oh, hell. I wonder if he knows about Dad.
There's you all standing there, real worried. Poor old Reb lost her memory. I reckon you ought to enter the talent show, Reb. You'd win best actress for sure. Drop it, Kelly.
Hey, when's the payoff coming, huh?
When's the big punchline, eh?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Neither do we. Oh, all this garbage about her brother.
Yeah, well, it's true.
Oh, yeah, sure.
I bet you'd be dead keen to find out about your old man. Get it? Dead keen.
Yeah, well, what do you mean?
Know what I mean? Your brother's dead. He's dead as a doornail. You killed him when you wrapped that car around a tree.
I know.
That's why your mum and dad wiped you. You murdered your own brother.
Oh, no. No!
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines. The sun and rain are prisoners too. When morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together. Sharing